stroke.
Querida.
Thank you, darling.
I can't believe this. I was out playing in traffic, and I didn't get hit by a single car. What did I do to deserve such luck? Aha!
Good idea, Fester. Taking unnecessary chances is a surefire way to reverse your fortunes.
Let's hope it worked. Flip a coin. Heck!
Sorry, you win.
Darn! How am I ever gonna shake this lucky streak?
Beats me.
Poor Fist.
Mother, an animal followed me home from school today. Can I keep it, please?
Dear Pugsley, such a gentle soul. Always taking in some stray scorpion or a rabid coyote.
So, can I keep it?
I suppose so. What is it this time?
Why, it's a horse, of course.
Ah, there's nothing like bare stems to cheer up a room.
Giddy up, giddy up!
Is it time for school already?
I believe so. We should really have a talk with Pugsley. He hasn't been late once since he started riding National Velour to school. Oh, dear. We're all out of Mama's mutant mulch.
And amazingly, here she is to help us make more.
Tell you what, you slice, I'll dice. One batch of mutant mulch coming right up.
Ah, the enticing aroma of spoiled vegetation. I can't resist.
Gomez.
Gomez.
Mama?
I know. One antidote coming up.
And put it in a big glass.
Any idea who National Velour's rightful owners are?
Not a clue. Darling, maybe we should take a break.
Aha! So you admit defeat!
Darn! I can't even get a good head injury these days.
I wonder who that could be.
Maybe it's a disgruntled neighbor. I'll get it. Won't you come in?
Hello. I'm Jack Schmid, and this is my wife, Audrey.
Nice to meet you. I'm Gomez Adams. This is my lovely wife, Morticia, and my fascinating brother, Fester.
Hi.
We're sorry to bother you, but we're looking for our racehorse, National Velour.
Yes, apparently it's been spotted in your neighborhood.
What a coincidence. Our son Pugsley found a striking thoroughbred with the same name.
Yeah. Anyway, you might want to leave us your number in case we see your horse.
Oh, would you mind terribly if we took a look at this National Velour your son found?
Not at all. Right this way.
Are you not the least bit concerned about National Velour?
Of course I am, dear.
Pugsley keeps him down here in the playroom.
National Velour! You're saved!
do our best to make our guests feel at home. Don't forget to drive recklessly!
Oh, dear. I hope Pugsley won't be too upset when he finds out we gave National Velour back to his rightful owners.
Don't worry, Kitty. Our boy's a trooper. He'll be just fine.
I've never seen our son so despondent.
There must be something in here that'll cheer Pugsley up.
Pugsley says he's never going to speak to you or Mother again.
Well, at least he's dealing with his anger in an unproductive manner.
I know. I'll put a happiness potion in his cereal. That'll keep him grinning from ear to ear.
I can't stand to think of him looking like that.
Ah, here it is! Just the thing that makes Pugsley feel better.
I can't even get 7 years bad luck.
So you see, little Ford, riding a mechanical horse is just as much fun as riding a real thing.
I don't know.
Sure it is. I'll prove it to you. Lester, let's show the boy what real horsepower is.
Gotcha.
Give this baby some juice.
All right.
Nothing seems to cheer Pugsley up.
Here he comes. Now leave everything to me. I'll take his mind off of National Velour.
Pugsley, how are you feeling?
Lonely.
Hey, Pugsley. How'd you like to play a little game of horseshoes?
Way to go, Dr. Feelgood.
You still miss National Velour, don't you?
Here, Pugsley. You might as well take my lightning rod. I'm never going to get hit by lightning with my luck anyway.
Bye, George. Why didn't we think of this before? Let's go down to the racetrack and watch National Velour in action.
Really?
Sure. We'll have a day at the races.
Yay!
Gomez, this track is rife with human despair and misery. Ah, les misérables.
Tisha, it's French. Well, Lure's finally up.
Do you think he'll win?
Oh, I hope so. If not, I'm afraid he's headed for greater pastures.
Bet you wouldn't be so upset if it was me going to greater pastures.
So you do understand.
Sure bet, because he was sure to lose. They gave me the wrong ticket.
guess that's the end for National Velour.
Greater pasture, you said?
I'm sorry your horse came in last.
Thanks, Wednesday.
Maybe next time he'll come in second to last.
There won't be a next time. This needs to say they're sending him to greater pastures, whatever that means.
Pugsley, greater pastures is just another way of saying the great beyond.
Huh? Wednesday, we can't let them do that. We have to stop them.
Why?
Because it'll be miserable if we don't.
Seriously.
Because it'll be no fun torturing me if I'm already beyond despair.
To save National Velour, we must.
Now don't move a muscle, darling. I'm almost finished painting you. There. All done.
I'll get it. Gomez Adams here. Ah, Mrs. Sneed. I see. Well, I can assure you our son does not have your horse. On second thought, let me get back to you.
Wednesday, what do you like best about horses?
That they eat small boys when others aren't looking.
Wednesday, Pugsley, do you have anything you want to tell us?
No, Mother. I mean, Mother.
Now, son, we need to have a talk.
And I thought you were going to punish him.
Pugsley, come have a seat. Now, Pugsley, the life of a horse thief is not an easy one.
It isn't?
It's not as glamorous as it sounds.
Pugsley, what we're trying to say is you must return National Velour. I know it's hard, but he belongs to the Sneeds.
But...
Now, Pugsley, I don't want to hear any more arguments. National Velour is going back, and that's final.
Yes, Father.
Wednesday, what are we going to do?
Lighting three sticks of dynamite off the same match. The unluckiest thing a demolitionist can do. That's it. I give up.
Uncle Fester, Lurch, I need you to help me with something.
Sure. What do you want us to do?
Dress up like a horse and let the Sneeds take you away.
Oh, and I thought you wanted us to do something silly.
Then it's settled.
But...
As you wish.
Mr. and Mrs. Adams? Smedley, I'm from Greater Pastures.
Of course, I'll have my son bring National Velour around. Pugsley? Pugsley?
Oh, dear. You better go upstairs and make sure nothing's wrong.
Mr. and Mrs. Adams?
Strange. National Velour isn't here either.
I'm suffocating in here. Feels good.
Children! There you are.
Where's National Velour?
We put him in the horse trailer. Pugsley hates long goodbyes, so it'd be best if you leave now. And don't look back.
Oh. Okay. Bye. Yep. Here he is. Safe and sound.
Thank you.
Maquicia.
Do please, do please. Thy name is Gomez.
I must tame you, my shrew.
Darling, you haven't called me that in weeks.
So, want to go to the dungeon and slip into some shackles?
Darling, I thought you'd never ask.
Not so fast. The dungeon is closed for the evening. Come back tomorrow. Our hours are noon to 12.
Wednesday, what's going on?
Nothing. Now hold still, National Velour.
Pugsley?
Nice try, children.
I can explain. It's all Pugsley's fault.
Oh.
Look, admirable as it is to completely disregard our orders, the Sneeds missed their horse.
But the only reason why they want National Velour back is so they can, well, you know.
But the Sneeds would never harm National Velour.
But they said they were going to send him to Greater Pastures.
Pugsley's son, Greater Pastures is a retirement farm for racehorses.
It is?
Of course.
Told you.
You know, I'll bet the Sneeds could use someone to take National Velour on walks and maybe feed him from time to time.
As a matter of fact, I remember Mrs. Sneed saying she was looking for just such a person.
I'll do it.
Then it's all settled. I'll have Fester and Lurch take National Velour to Greater Pastures first thing in the morning. By the way, where are Fester and Lurch anyway?
Lurch, is National Velour a girl's name?
The Fester and Lurch for their daring escape from Greater Pastures.
How lovely everything worked out for the best.
Then why not? With all my good luck.
Fester, what is that stuck to your shoe?
It's a four-leaf clover. No wonder I've been so lucky. There. That ought to curse me again.
Mother, Father, an animal followed me home from school. Can I keep it? Please?
What is it this time? A hyena? Or a Tasmanian devil?
A giant radioactive lizard monster?
How'd you guess?
My luck has changed. For the worse.
Gentle soul. Always taking in some stray scorpion or a rabid coyote.
So, can I keep it?
I suppose so. What is it this time?
Why, it's a horse, of course.
Ah, there's nothing like bare stems to cheer up a room.
Giddy up, giddy up!
Is it time for school already?
I believe so. We should really have a talk with Pugsley. He hasn't been late once since he started riding National Velour to school. Oh, dear. We're all out of Mama's mutant mulch.
And amazingly, here she is to help us make more.
Tell you what. You slice, I'll dice.
A mutant mulch coming right up.
Ah, the enticing aroma of spoiled vegetation. I can't resist.
Gomez.
Gomez.
Mama?
I know. One antidote coming up.
And put it in a big glass.
Any idea who National Velour's rightful owners are?
Not a clue. Darling, maybe we should take a break.
Aha! So you admit defeat!
Darn, I can't even get a good head injury these days.
I wonder who that could be.
Maybe it's a disgruntled neighbor. I'll get it. Won't you come in?
Hello. I'm Jack Schmid, and this is my wife, Audrey.
Nice to meet you.
I'm Gomez Adams.
This is my lovely wife, Morticia, and my fascinating brother, Fester.
Hi.
We're sorry to bother you, but we're looking for our racehorse, National Velour.
Yes, apparently it's been spotted in your neighborhood.
Well, what a coincidence. Our son Pugsley found a striking thoroughbred with the same name.
Yeah. Anyway, you might want to leave us your number in case we see your horse.
Oh, would you mind terribly if we took a look at this National Velour your son found?
Not at all. Right this way.
Stroke.
Thank you, darling.
I can't believe this. I was out playing in traffic, and I didn't get hit by a single car. What did I do to deserve such luck? Aha!
Good idea, Fester. Taking unnecessary chances is a surefire way to reverse your fortunes.
Let's hope it worked. Flip a coin. Heads.
Sorry, you win.
Darn! How am I ever gonna shake this lucky streak?
Beats me.
Poor Fist.
Mother, an animal followed me home from school today. Can I keep it, please?
Dear Pugsley, such a jerk.
Are you not the least bit concerned about National Velour?
Of course I am, dear.
Pugsley keeps him down here in the playroom. Always do our best to make our guests feel at home. Don't forget to drive recklessly!
Oh, dear. I hope Pugsley won't be too upset when he finds out we gave National Velour back to his rightful owners.
Don't worry, Kenita. Our boy's a trooper. He'll be just fine.
Our son so despondent.
There must be something in here that'll cheer Pugsley up.
Pugsley says he's never going to speak to you or mother again.
Well, at least he's dealing with his anger in an unproductive manner.
I know. I'll put a happiness potion in his cereal. That'll keep him grinning from ear to ear.
I can't stand to think of him looking like that.
Ah, here it is.
just the thing that makes Pugsley feel better.
I can't even get 7 years bad luck.
So you see, little Pug, riding a mechanical horse is just as much fun as riding a real thing.
I don't know.
Sure it is. I'll prove it to you. Lester, let's show the boy what real horsepower is.
Gotcha.
Nothing seems to cheer Pugsley up.
Here he comes. Now leave everything to me. I'll take his mind off of National Velour.
Pugsley, how are you feeling?
Lonely.
Hey, Pugsley. How'd you like to play a little game of horseshoes?